This video is an introduction to the pharmacology of antiseptics and disinfectants. We'll also focus on the disinfecting properties of alcohol. Let's start with some short definitions. Antiseptics are antimicrobial substances that are applied to living tissue, such as skin, to reduce the possibility of infection by killing microorganisms or inhibiting their growth. Disinfectants are chemical agents designed to inactivate or destroy microorganisms on non-living surfaces, such as surgical instruments. Okay, so just to clarify once again, antiseptics and disinfectants both kill microorganisms. An antiseptic is applied to the body, while disinfectants are applied to non-living surfaces. Disinfectants are generally distinguished from other antimicrobial agents, such as antibiotics, which destroy microorganisms within the body. Alcohols can destroy fungi, viruses, and bacteria. I will show their mechanism of action on a bacterial cell first. The components of the bacterial cell are cell wall, cytoplasmic membrane, cytoplasm, proteins embedded in the cell membrane, proteins inside the cell, and DNA. The cell wall of gram-positive bacteria consists of thick peptidoglycan and periplasmic space followed by the cytoplasmic membrane. The cell wall of gram-negative bacteria consists of outer membrane, a thin peptidoglycan layer which is penetrated easier by the alcohol, periplasmic space, and then cytoplasmic membrane. In the healthcare setting, alcohol refers to two water-soluble chemical compounds, ethyl alcohol and isopropyl alcohol. So, without further ado, let's study the mechanism of action and indications of alcohol as antiseptic and disinfectant. I will represent the molecule of alcohol with this red dot. When alcohol molecules bind with the cell membrane encasing a bacterial cell, the fat membrane is broken down, and the inside of the cell, including all of its critical components, becomes exposed to other molecules of alcohol. Alcohol molecules penetrate peptidoglycan, as you can see. Alcohol can induce bacterial cell lysis. Alcohol will act on proteins embedded in the cell membrane and proteins inside the cell. Proteins in the tertiary state have different types of side-chain interactions, such as hydrogen bonds, hydrophobic interactions, ionic bonds, and disulfide bridges. Alcohols denature proteins mainly by disrupting the intramolecular hydrogen bonding between the side-chains, which is essential to maintain the tertiary protein structure. Besides, some alcohols can also interact with the hydrophobic residues in a protein, destroying its hydrophobic core. Because of these two factors, the tertiary structure of the protein molecule will be destroyed, and the protein will denature. Here you can see how the protein shape is altered due to denaturation. If the proteins in the cell membrane and inside the cell are denatured, they will no longer be able to carry out their cellular function. Alcohol can also dehydrate the bacterial cell. Can a cell survive without functional proteins? Of course not, and let's not forget that alcohol also induces cell lysis. The bacterium will die. Alcohols are most effective when combined with distilled water to facilitate diffusion through the cell membrane. 100% alcohol typically denatures only external membrane proteins. Usually, gram-negative bacteria like Pseudomonas aeruginosa and E. coli are killed in 10 seconds by all concentrations of ethanol from 40% to 100%. The gram-positive organisms like Staphylococcus aureus and Streptococcus pyogenes were slightly more resistant, being killed in 10 seconds by ethyl alcohol concentrations of 60% to 95%. Isopropyl alcohol or isopropanol was slightly more bactericidal than ethyl alcohol. Alcohols are not recommended for sterilizing medical and surgical equipment, principally because they lack sporicidal action. They can't penetrate protein-rich materials like bacterial spores. Let's discuss how alcohol affects Mycobacterium tuberculosis. The components of the mycobacterial cell are cell wall, cytoplasmic membrane, cytoplasm, proteins embedded in the cell membrane, proteins inside the cell, and DNA. The mycobacterial cell wall consists of peptidoglycan, arabinogalactan, mycolic acid, and other lipids. The mechanism of action of alcohols is the same as in bacteria. It breaks the cell membrane, may induce mycobacterial cell lysis, and denatures proteins inside the cell and those in the cell membrane. Without functional proteins, the mycobacterium will die. In tests of the effect of ethyl alcohol against Mycobacterium tuberculosis, 95% ethanol killed the bacilli in sputum or water suspension within 15 seconds. Alcohol can also kill viruses. There are two types of viruses, lipophilic and hydrophilic. Lipophilic viruses have a lipid envelope. Viruses that don't have a lipid envelope are called hydrophilic or water-loving viruses. The components of the virus are viral envelope, glycoproteins, nucleic acid, capsid, which is composed of proteins, and we also have proteins inside the capsid. When alcohol molecules bind with the fat membrane encasing a virus, the membrane is broken down, and the inside of the virus particle, including all of its critical components, like proteins, becomes exposed to alcohol, which will denature proteins, and this is deadly for the virus. Alcohol can also penetrate the viral capsid and denature proteins inside, and maybe it can denature capsomeres too. Ethyl alcohol at concentrations of 60% to 80% is a potent virucidal agent, inactivating all of the lipophilic viruses, for example herpes, vaccinia, and influenza viruses, and many hydrophilic viruses, for example adenovirus, enterovirus, rhinovirus, and rhodaviruses. Let's show how alcohol affects yeasts and fungi. The components of the fungal cell are cell wall, cell membrane, proteins embedded in the cell membrane, proteins inside the cell, and DNA inside the nucleus. The cell wall of fungi is composed of chitin, beta-glucans, mannans, and glycoproteins. When it comes to yeasts and fungi, the mechanism of action is still the same. Alcohol penetrates through the cell wall, then breaks the fat membrane, may induce cell lysis, and denatures proteins inside the cell and those in the cell membrane. Good news! Without functional proteins, the fungus will die. Now, pay attention to the concentration. 70% ethyl alcohol was the most effective concentration for killing the tissue phase of Cryptococcus neoformans, Blastomyces dermatitis, Coccidioides immitis, and Histoplasma capsulatum. Before we end, let's discuss the use of alcohol in medicine. Alcohols applied to the skin are used to disinfect it before a needle stick and before surgery. They may be used both to disinfect the skin of the person and the hands of the healthcare provider. Alcohols have been used effectively to disinfect oral and rectal thermometers, hospital pagers, scissors, and stethoscopes. Alcohols have been used to disinfect fiber optic endoscopes and external surfaces. This concludes our lecture. Thank you for watching.